Hi folks, I'm going to show you how you can create a tour in Google Earth. In this video, for demonstration purpose, we are going to select two oceans, the Arctic Ocean and the Indian Ocean. One of the first things I recommend is to organize your files and to have all the places related to a particular tour in a single folder. So let's get started. So I'm going to go to My Places, right click on My Places, go to Add and add a folder, and I'm going to call this folder Oceans. As you can see, any folder that you create gets created under My Places. So I'm going to search for the Arctic Ocean, and once I get the Arctic Ocean, I'm going to right click on Arctic Ocean and select Save to My Places. As you can see, it gets created under My Places. So what I'm going to do is drag and drop it on Oceans so that now it is inside the Oceans folder. I'm going to search for our second ocean, the Indian Ocean. And once again, once I get the Indian Ocean, I'm going to right click on Indian Ocean and select Save to My Places. Once again, it's going to get created under My Places. So I'm going to drag and drop it on the Oceans folder. So the first method that I'm going to show you is the fully automated tour, wherein Google Earth is going to take care of the whole tour for you. So in order to do that, what we're going to do is select the Oceans folder, and as you can see, a new button got created called as Play Tour. So we're going to click on this button and that generates our tour. The moment you click this button, as you can see, a mini player pops up. Of course, you have the play and pause button that lets you stop and play the video at any point. Then you have the reverse button that lets you play the video in reverse. And of course, you're going to have the forward button that lets you play the video in forward. In addition, you have a button that lets you play it in a loop. Now we will see three characteristics that occur when you completely depend on Google Earth for creating your tour. The first one is going to be a balloon pop-up. The second one is a fly-through of the boundary of the object. And the third one is the extent of the object that is defined by the boundary. So as you can see, this is the balloon pop-up that I was talking about. Then we have the fly-through, wherein Google Earth is going to go and fly through the entire boundary of the object. And sometimes it can be really confusing if you're not paying attention. So I'm going to pause the tour here and let's go back to the beginning, or the place where the fly-through actually began. What really happens is, for the places that are defined within Google Earth, Google has defined an boundary around the object. So it's going to try and traverse along this boundary whenever possible. So in order to get rid of this automated flying, first let's close this tour and we'll go to Tools, and then we'll go to Options, and under the Touring tab, as you can see, I'm going to uncheck the fly along lines and uncheck the show balloon option. Now, once you do that, you're going to see that if we again play this tour, it's not going to fly along this square and directly move on to the next object. I'm going to speed up the tour so that we can quickly see the effect. As you can see, this time it did not go through the boundary but directly onto the next object. Now the second problem with this is that it still snaps to the boundary even if it doesn't fly through the boundary. So to remove this, what we're going to do is zoom in to the region that we feel comfortable or needs to be displayed and go and add a place marker. I'm going to call this Indian Ocean. You can name it whatever you want, even if it matches with the one recorded by Google Earth. So I'm going to remove Indian Ocean, and I'm going to take my Indian Ocean and place it above Google's Arctic Ocean. Now if I zoom out and I again select the Oceans folder and play the tour, we see that this time it is going to zoom into the region that I felt comfortable to represent Indian Ocean. In this way, you can create your own places and do not have to be constrained by the places defined inside of Google Earth. Now I like the tour, so I'm going to go ahead and save this tour. Thank you all for watching and hope you learned something today. If you liked the video, please don't forget to click like, share and subscribe to my channel.